Hello, welcome to my channel in Mechanical Engineering Concept. Today I am going to discuss about basic of machine design concept, in which I am going to discuss about mode of failure, different types of mode of failure which are occur in a machine design element. One thing I wanted to tell you basically, in a strength of material and machine design, basic difference is that in a strength of material we basically considering a plane section will remain plane before and after failure or fracture or a component failure. But in a machine design, we are not considering that the component will fail or a plane section will remain plane before and after failure. The basic differences between machine design and strength of material is that. And in a mode of failure, we know that when a mechanical component is called fail, if it is unable to perform its desirable function or satisfactorily. Means that whenever the mechanical component or machine element will unable to perform its function, basic function for which it is designed or for which it is manufactured or for which it is value is calculated or which is analyzed, so we cannot say that component is has a desired function or have a unable to perform its function. So for static loading, the failure can be different basically types. Three types of failure can occur in a static loading condition. First one is elastic deformation. Elastic deformation, as we know that from a stress strain diagram, the member such as shaft, beam, column are different basic mechanical component can have elastic deflection beyond the allowable limit, in which elastic deflection vanishes after removal of load from the member. It means whenever we apply load in a component within the limit of elasticity, and whenever the load is removed from the component will have a elastic deflection. This is the first type of failure of a static loading condition, which is removed whenever the load is removed. Second one is the yielding failure. Yielding failure or a yielding type of failure, a component made up of ductile material loses its engineering usefulness due to significant amount of plastic deformation under exceeding the yielding stress. It means whenever the component or whenever the ductile material component it has a static loading condition, the component will loses its significance due to plastic deformation occur in a yield stress, above the yield stress. Whenever the component will have a yielding stress or component will exceed its yielding stress, then the component will have a yielding failure. It is due to plastic deformation. First one will be the due to elastic deformation, second one will be due to the plastic deformation. Next failure will be the fracture, a component made up of brittle material. Previous yielding will occur in a ductile material and the fracture will occur in a brittle material. Because as we know that from the stress strain diagram for ductile and brittle material, in a ductile material we can see elasticity, yielding and further necking and ultimate stress point, but in a brittle material we cannot see elasticity and yielding in a macroscopic level or a naked eye level. So we need to say that a component made up of brittle material failed due to sudden fracture. Whenever the load is exceeding above the permissible value, the component failed suddenly fracture without any plastic deformation. This is known as a fracture failure. This is the basic three types of mode of failure which we need to consider. Next major important topic will be the factor of safety. What do you mean by factor of safety? So this is the basic important topic which we need to understand before going to the machine design of any machine element. So factor of safety can be defined as the ratio of failure stress divided by working or a allowable stress. It is a ratio of failure stress to allowable stress or a working stress. It means that a component can fail at failure stress and component can save below the allowable stress or equal to the allowable stress. So it is the value of maximum stress divided by nominal stress. So why we need to use factor of safety? So basic reason is that is the to ensure sufficient reserve strength in the component. The design process usually consider a factor of safety, because when we design a component for a static load or for dynamic loading, we cannot say the load will not change at any point of a time. So when we design a component for design safety, we basically consider factor of safety. Whenever the load will change, the component will not have to fail. So to ensure that, we need to provide reserve strength in a component to save the component or machine element. So due to that, we use factor of safety. So in general, for ductile material, we use tensile stress and shear stress in yielding condition at yielding condition, and for brittle material we use ultimate stress for brittle material condition. What are the basic value we can consider for factor of safety? Here are some basic example. In aircraft engineering, factor of safety ranges from 1.5 to 2, approximately 1.5 to 2. Factor of safety is a unitless number. Next example will be the for design of stationary engineering structure like column, beam, of prolonged service factor of safety ranges of factor of safety from 2 to 5. So we basically consider value like for a stationary engineering element, factor of safety will be 2 to 5, and for aircraft engine approximately 1.5 to 2. It can be changed from 1.5 to less than 1.5 or more than 2, but approximately it ranges from 1.5 to 2. So I hope you understand the basic concept about machine design and failure about machine design and factor of safety. If you have any doubt, then please tell me below the comment section below the video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.